Sprague.
To say, hey, I'm an assistant town clerk in my town now, and I want a bunch of tickets, so maybe someday I can be a town clerk in Old Saybrook. But I need a place. How about Willington? They're looking for a town clerk. I'll go there and I'll put in a couple of years as a town clerk. I can apply, and here's my certification, so I know they'll hire me because I'm certified. And now I can be there for 2 years, and then I can move on down the road, and Willington can hire another one. Donna does things up there that she doesn't really have to do. I've heard, well, you know, Tom Farkle, no matter who we hire, they're going to have to do their job. I agree, but she does things she doesn't have to. For anybody who's played politics in the town, got involved with the political system in the town, she's a big help. Because when you walk in, they go, oh, you know, here's the calendar, which is like the ancient Aztec calendars with all its meetings and mysteries, and she solves them. She'll give you a call and say, no, you know, tomorrow you have to have this in. Now, she's not required to do that by law, but it's very nice that she does. And she helps keep things running smoothly. She doesn't do that because she's a member of the town. She knows the people. So I guess this comes down to me as being a matter of if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And I think we've been doing pretty good as it is. And I think we should stay that way. So, I don't think that we need to change this.
Okay. Now can I go? Because first I find that very insulting. Because I work for a different municipality, and let me tell you, I give them 110%. I act like I live there. So you can't say someone's going to come into our town and they're not going to give it, go above and beyond because they're not a town resident. Because that's baloney, first. Second of all, we want somebody in here who's qualified and who does the work and make sure that we don't get in any trouble down the road because we're not doing what we're supposed to be doing. And the same could happen. A Willington resident could get that job, get certified, and a job could open up in Tallinn 2 years from now, and they could leave and say, see ya, I got my certification, thank you, Willington. So just because, you can't say because it's a Willington resident or an out-of-town resident that it's going to happen if we have an out-of-town resident, and it's not going to happen if we have a Willington resident, because that's baloney too. And would I ideally like a Willington resident there? Sure, that would be great. That would be great. And we will have the last say. So if you have somebody who's got qualifications and you have a Willington resident who we know can handle the job if they're qualified, well, who's to say we're going to pick the person with the qualifications and not the person, the Willington resident who we know can handle it? You know, I don't know. I know that position needs to be filled by somebody who is going to make sure that things are getting done so that we don't get fined down the road. And when you have someone who's elected, they're not accountable to anybody. They're accountable to the people, but who pays attention? Who pays attention? Who knows what that clerk is supposed to do? How many residents have come in and say, you know what, I haven't seen her file minutes on time. They don't know. People don't know that, but we know. And when we get fined, we're going to know. So you talk about checks and balances. There is no checks and balances for that position right now. Okay, I'm done. Sorry.
Yeah, I will stand.
And the other issue is really about vacation time and things like that, where you know there's five positions, right? There's town clerk, first selectman, treasurer, and the registrars, who really don't have. It's just a stipend. There's no set amount of time. There's no set hours that you're supposed to work, and there's no set vacation time that you're allowed to take or whatever. So it's just a little different with the town clerk and the treasurer in particular, because they in both, nobody's taking advantage of it, but it could easily be taken advantage of, and that's the thing that you. We watch it. We have a pretty onerous system for vacation and tracking and accruals and things like that here. And those two positions are, and the first selectman and the registrars, you could just decide not to come in. And then you still have to pay. And then at some point, you know, I don't even know what happens in that situation. But that's where there's no checks and balances. And, you know, we've been lucky. We've been lucky. So I don't know, I just don't think that we want to push our luck. I don't think we need to push our luck. That's the thing. And the other thing is, I mean, that's just my opinion. Kim has an opinion, you have an opinion. I think everybody has an opinion. This is a rare opportunity where people, I think people deserve to have the opportunity to say what they think and to vote on it.
Yeah.
Well, I think you're saying that you just don't want it. I think you're advocating that we just stop talking about it and stop doing anything about it. But that would mean that the three of us decide we're not doing this. I think that it should definitely be something that we present to the people, because chances like these don't come along very often.
Well, obviously there's always going to be different issues which one or more selectmen might not want to do, one or more selectmen might want to do, and that's one reason they have the ordinances and the
mm-hmm.
avenue to follow on those.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, I don't think it's a good idea. Obviously, I'm not going to want to thwart it.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, the other option is to petition it. If there were that many people in town who wanted it to be done, what do you need, 20 people to petition for a town meeting?
Yeah. So
even if I say no and you guys say yes, I guess you're going to outvote me. I'm not sure how we do that.
Well, I think if two of us voted no, then the public wanted it, then they could petition for us to have a town meeting.
Correct.
And then it could be further petitioned to be a vote.
Correct.
But if we want it to be a town meeting, I don't think anyone can petition for it not to be.
I have a question. Why do you want to change it for? Basically, why do you want to change it?
Why?
Yeah.
Because we don't have a check and balance over it. And most of the towns, or at least the towns that I know of around here, have all made the change. Not just with the town clerk, but with their treasurer as well. And just as we did with our tax collector and with our assessor. And it's just, there's a lot of things that you have to know. So it
if the things that the state requires us to do are not getting done in the clerk's office, we can be fined for that. We can pay some hefty fines. We want to make sure it's getting done. But there's no way that the Board of Selectmen, we don't have any say because it's an elected position. So whatever happens there can happen there, and we have no say. Somebody could be out for 6 months. We have no say. It's an elected position. There's no checks and balances of that position at all, except for the public. And nobody who pays attention to that. How often do you go down there and make sure they're doing their job? You know, people don't know. You go down there, you get your dog license, you're happy. You know, that's what most people, they go down there, they get what they want, and they're happy. But is everything being done that needs to be done? Does that make sense? Is everything being done that needs to be?
The person that takes that job should be doing it.
Well,
that they should know
so.
It.
Right, but well, if they don't, what if they don't? What? You have to wait 4 years.
It's like anything else. If they don't do it, what do you do about it?
You'd have to wait 4 years.
If it's elected, you have to wait to the next election. If it's appointed, you can take disciplinary action.
Have we ever had a elected position around here where we had someone who was not doing the job?
Yeah. It's probably different. Yeah, there's a lot of different opinions on that.
Well, let me put it this way, where someone was not doing to the job, whereas Kim keeps pointing out that the town was fined.
I didn't say it was fined, I said it could be fined. It could be fined.
It's like you, how do we know you're doing your job? I don't know it.
Yeah.
None of us do it, except you three people.
Well, we have meetings every other week, and there's a board, and I mean, I'd like to.
She does give them.
If I was, if I really screwed up something, everybody would know about it. Corey's here from the paper, he'd write all about it.
Well, you can't rely on everything you read either. That's one thing I find out.
That is the truth.
You know what I'm saying?
Unless Corey's.
Yeah, especially Fox News.
No, but I'm just saying is that, you know, why accept the apple cart and it's working fine now, you know? And now the other part too is that the person coming in, you like her, he don't like her, well, I don't want her in there. See, that's a point where you can play the game too. You could say yes or no to put her in, and she's qualified, but you still don't want her, or him or whatever. Yeah, I mean, it's a favoritism game, where with elected officers, everybody's got something to say about it. We all can vote either way, yes or no.
I saw Peter's hand up.
If I might ask a question, because I agree with Kim, none of us know a great deal about this. I sense Christina and Kim want to make a change. I'm sensing John is not. You have the advantage of having a town attorney at your disposal. Something we don't have. And you're saying he's suggesting there are ways to make this change as we have in the past with the other positions. Mm-hmm. What are the pros and cons? Can he give us both sides? What are the advantages of having an elected position? What are the advantages and disadvantages of having an appointed position? It always seems like when you guys get the town attorney to stake something out, it's always what you want to do. We never see both sides of it because you ask for what support for what you want. That may be good, it may be bad, but can he say elected positions offer these advantages and disadvantages, appointed positions provide these advantages and disadvantages, and then we can all read about it and make an informed decision.
I didn't ask the attorney that question. I asked the town managers and the other selectmen of the neighboring towns what they see as the pros and cons. And we've talked about it at other meetings before, so that's why, I mean, this isn't just a surprise that we're talking about this today, but.
Do you understand what I'm saying, though?
But we did tell you the pros and cons.
May have been reasons why this was an elected position, like John says, for so many years. What are they? I don't know.
Why it's elected, or what the pros and cons? Because that's the way it was before we got here. I don't know why it was elected.
I'm guessing there's more to it than that.
Historically, all these positions, going way back to colonial times, were elected.
Right. Right.
And little by little, some jobs became appointed as time went on. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not the end of the world if we change it to an appointed. I just think we're better off having it as an elected position. I'm looking at the list here that you made, thank you. Commission, let's say? towns that now appoint their town clerks as opposed to towns that elect them. And looks like most of the smaller towns have continued to elect. A few of the bigger towns have. Ashford elects, Ansonia elects, Avon, a little bit bigger, has appointed.
Chaplin appoints.
Who does?
Chaplin, and they only have 2,200.
Chaplin? No, it doesn't.
Well, isn't the little star say they appoint?
Yeah.
Wasn't that by Chaplin, or
does
that mean?
You're looking at the...
Oh, that's, they have a tax collector.
You're looking at Canton.
Oh, yeah. I'm looking at tax... Oh, where am I? Oh, clerk, so sorry. I'm sorry, I'm looking in the wrong column.
Yeah, Columbia appoints. Coventry appoints, and those are two that I talked to.
And what did they say?
That, you know, that there's accountability, that... you know, that you can plan for vacations, you can do all that stuff that we can't really do now. Right now, if our treasurer or our town clerk has a medical issue and they're out for a couple of months, well, we haven't budgeted for how to cover that. We still have to pay them. They're not gonna be here. We have to get someone to come and fill in for them. We have to pay those people. So then we have a budget issue. But if they were appointed, then they would be using their paid time off. They would go into the family medical leave. They would be dipping into the sick bank. It would get covered a different way. It would be covered. It wouldn't be a thing. And that's one of the issues. I mean, I really don't care either way. It doesn't affect me personally. It doesn't affect, I mean, I think either way we're going to get someone who's going to be able to do the job, because I don't think any party is going to be nominating anyone who wouldn't be able to do the job. But there's a lot more to the job than I think people realize, to both jobs. I guess I put together a better pro and con list for the meeting when we talk about it at the town meeting, but it's not a, we certainly wouldn't be the first town to go that way.
Yeah, I noticed that when you went to the town attorney, he came up with one thing here, which kind of raised my eyebrows.
About the first selectman.
Yeah, his term,
yeah.
Draft language for the ordinance would have the term of any appointed town clerk shall terminate on the same date as the term of the first selectman, except such appointee may continue to serve until the successor is appointed and qualified.
Yeah.
And I was,
whoa. Well, they thought that it was important that there would be a clear end of the appointment term. Mm-hmm. But then I found the language from that we have for our tax collector and said, can we just use this instead, which is much better. It says, the Board of Selectmen shall perform an evaluation of, it says tax collector in that ordinance, but I changed it to town clerk, each year in the month of April. Such evaluation shall be based upon the effectiveness and abilities of the town clerk as described in the job qualifications. Should the Board of Selectmen find in their evaluation that, in their opinion, the town clerk is not fulfilling the requirements of the position, they shall dismiss the town clerk pursuant to the Connecticut General Statutes as amended from time to time. Reappointment of a town clerk for a succeeding four-year term shall be carried out after the evaluation and before the appointment expires. Failure of the Board of Selectmen to make a reappointment shall result in the town clerk's renewal for a four-year term.
So that's the part I'm confused about, though. So they're appointed, but only for a four-year term?
Yeah. And that's true with the
assessor.
The assessor and the
tax collector.
The building official.
And the registrars.
Yeah. Well, the registrars are
elected. Yeah, but they're elected.
Control officer. So they have to have they're appointed for not forever, but for a set amount of time. That
but
rolls.
Usually that just kind of just keeps rolling over.
Yeah, yeah. Usually we fail, you know, or.
Yeah, one thing that really, when I was looking at the tax collector's thing, I saw the same thing as you did. One thing that really kind of sick, failure of the Board of Selectmen to make a reappointment shall result in the town clerk's renewal of a four-year term. Why did they put that in there?
Because if we don't reappoint them, because uh-huh. we forget that their four-year term is up and they don't remind us, and then it's our fault, and
they don't remind us, yeah.
They don't have actually
forgotten.
Yes,
have forgotten.
Have we ever appointed Mary Huda several times?
Yeah.
Have we?
Did
Can you do a yearly evaluation of the tax collector?
Well, we're planning on it. She hasn't been here a year yet. But we did not know, Carol, no.
Oh, okay.
We could have, but.
Well, apparently we were supposed to, but.
Yeah. I think if Carol, the thing is, if we're having a problem with someone.
Yeah.
Then I bet we would.
Well, we.
But we should probably just get in the practice of just doing it because that's what we're supposed to do.
Yeah.
Then if we did do it, would we wait till April if the problem surfaced in September?
Well, you don't have to wait for, you don't have to wait for that to, for, you have to wait for their evaluation for a problem. If there's a problem, you deal with it when it happens.
Yeah.
I lost it now.
Do you like that language by the way?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, actually, the way this reads it, would you, I think you would have to wait till April the way this reads.
But they would be an employee and they would be subject to our personnel policy, which has a whole thing about discipline. And, you know, basically, I don't think.
Was the employee policy supersede this?
No, not necessarily.
Ordinance would supersede the policy.
But this doesn't say that they're not subject to the personnel policy.
Can it be added?
Yeah, we could add something. I mean, and they wouldn't be able to be in the union either.
God, I hope not.
Yeah, well.
Well, it says it right here. The divorce second attorney, all fees collected by the town clerk shall be paid in town treasury. Town clerk may appoint and may remove subject to the approval of the divorce attorney subject to. Never mind. That's for the assistant town clerk. So the town clerk would still appoint the assistant town clerk?
Yep. Yeah, that's in the statute that they do that.
Okay.
Yeah, but I think the current assistant town clerk is indefinitely appointed.
Yeah.
So if she were to leave, then that would take her, right?
Unless they feel that she's not doing her job.
The assistant?
Right. What if the town clerk doesn't feel the assistant is doing the job?
Then she's an employee now.
Mm-hmm.
So she would be subject to our personnel policy and this, you know, progressive discipline and all that.
Okay.
You just don't like the idea of it. But if we were going to talk about it, you'd prefer it be done at a town meeting than have it be a referendum question?
I think so, yeah.
I understand where John's coming from on that. You know, if people care enough to come to the town meeting, then they should be the ones that vote. However, it's one town meeting, one time, and if you can't make it but you have a say on it, you can't be there to vote. Is that fair? No. So I understand what you're saying. I just think that give more people opportunity if you put it on the ballot. But
Yeah. Sorry. With the new ordinance for the registrars, that went to a voice vote at a town meeting. Sorry.
Yeah, I know.
I'm just saying.
You're right. I agree. I mean, if people care enough to come to the meeting, if they care enough about it, they'll come to the meeting and voice their opinion. It just, you know, it just puts it out there for everybody. But I agree. I mean, I don't have a preference, I...
Well, we could have it as a town meeting, and if people were, felt strongly about it, were compelled to, you know, have a petition and have it go to a referendum. I suppose they could do that. I don't know, I don't know, like, on the one hand, if people are gonna care all that, I really don't have a sense if people are gonna care one way or the other, or even care about the topic at all, but...
Well, obviously a couple of us do anyway,
yes.
But...
Mm-hmm.
And then, people who are out here care, going in both positions.
Yeah.
Well, so let's just do it at the town meeting. Let's just
have
it at the town meeting and
all right, and we don't need to, I mean, we can still, I can go back and talk to the town attorney about the personnel policy and make sure that this would not be a union position, because that is one thing that I'm assuming, I don't know that for sure. But,
yeah, we want to be careful with that.
And, yeah, because it's a department head. And then we'll come back. I mean, we don't have to rush. We don't rush.
Are we looking to do both the treasurer and the...
Well, that's the other thing, is if we're going to go with town clerk, do we go with town clerk and treasurer? I don't think we could even consider the registrar. It has to be electric. But
I don't think there are any. I don't think there's any appointment registrar.
No, I don't think so.
No.
You know, I'm sorry, Suzanne, I couldn't understand you.
There are not any appointed registrars in the state. They're all elected.
Is that required by statute?
Yes.
I believe it is, yeah.
The only thing that is, the statute says that the term is 2 years unless the town adopts an ordinance making it 4 years, which is what we did recently.
Right. I like that. That was done well.
And John, what's your thought on the treasurer? Because for me, I think that the treasurer is more important than town clerk. But you know what I mean? I mean, they get somebody who doesn't know what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's scary.
Well,
yeah.
That's
happening.
That's the kind of one I was trying to bring up. That we've had that happen in the past with the treasurer's position.
Mm-hmm.
The individual was appointed.
You were appointed, or
and then subsequently elected, appointed to fill a vacancy,
oh,
and
okay.
Then subsequently elected.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Were they subsequently elected?
It was an elected position.
Donna Lachinchuk's.
Who?
Donna Lachinchuk was appointed
as
treasurer and then subsequently elected.
No, we had a problem with another treasurer one time. Remember?
Who was elected?
Who was? I believe appointed to fill
a
vacancy.
Appointed to fill a vacancy, yeah.
And
never got to run for election because it
right.
Didn't last that long.
And that's my whole point. So there was an appointment to a position that...
But if you're not doing their job and they're appointed, you can be fired.
He was, well, he could not be fired any more than...
Because it was an appointment
he
to fill an elected
yeah.
position.
Because he got
right.
Pressure was put on.
Mm-hmm. Being appointed to fill an elected vacancy is different than being appointed.
Yes.
In this, under this.
Not necessarily. It depends on who's doing the appointing.
No, because once you're appointed, you're in an elected position. You're not in an appointed position.
I understand that. And
so the rules that govern elected officials would govern someone that's appointed to fill a vacancy for an elected office.
I understand that. But what I'm saying is, although this was an elected position, the problem we had was with a person who had been appointed to fill the position. And... That worked out, maybe not the best way in the world, but they did work it out and got somebody else in there.
Right, but what if they hadn't been able to work it out? What if the person refused to resign?
I don't know. Then I take him to court, start making him, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So there's got to be some legal way, because I know, like, but it was a treasurer down in Stonington or sometime that took all the town's money down to the casinos. I'm sure she got fired. I'm not sure how they fired her, but.
Well, it's tough to be treasurer if you're incarcerated.
You need to have her arrested. Yeah. Yeah, I don't think that's what they did.
Yeah. Well.
So that's something I really didn't want to bring out, but I really have to. That, you know, you're not gaining any guarantees by making an appointed position. And yes, if the person's not doing their job, then you can get them out there if they're appointed. If they're elected, I'm sure you could too. I think the state can remove the town clerk, can't they?
There's a legal process through the Secretary of State's office if a complaint is filed against the town clerk.
And again, that would be if they were not doing their job, which I don't think is a big worry with whoever gets in there. But again, I also like the idea of them being part of the town.
Yeah.
At the risk of stating the obvious, I would also respectfully suggest that for the treasurer's office, it's particularly important to have a degree of independence from whatever the current administration is of the Board of Selectmen, because we're talking about finance. Governments tend to be self-perpetuating institutions, and there's a fair amount of pressure on anyone within the town governmental body to support the budget because it's for the good of the town. I like the idea of the treasurer being independent of that and representing all the townspeople and being elected.
But there's still going to be pressure on from people in their own party who are in the Board of Finance.
But there's a
pressure
remedy.
On that. I mean, there could be pressure on anybody.
Because on the one hand, when people are appointed, then they're not. They're just employees at that point. It's not a political position. And I'm not sure why the town clerk should be a political position. It's not a political position. What does it matter if it's a Republican or a Democrat in that job?
If the town clerks are doing their job well, it doesn't matter if they're a Republican or a Democrat. And so far we've had really good luck with that. And I don't expect that will change, because it's just not the way this town runs. On the other hand, you do have